Hey there! In this video, I'm going to show you exactly how to add multiple filters to a single field in a pivot table. This little trick will make analyzing your data much easier, and best of all, it's really quick to set up. So let's dive in and get started. Right, let's apply a pivot table to this table of data. So we could do it from the Table Design tab here, or Insert tab, pivot table. And there we go. Right, now let's pop the contact down into the rows area, the account manager into the columns area, and the value down into the values area. Right, let's apply some filtering. So first up, I want to remove Steve's information. So we'll just get rid of Steve's info. Okay, now next thing I want to do is I don't want any of these email addresses in my list. So I'm just going to come up to the row labels, come down to the search box, pop an at sign in here, and that will allow me to filter and find anybody that's got an email address. Now I'm just going to remove the select all from here and add current selection to filter, which will eliminate all of these out of my results. And there we go. Lovely. Now, at this point, I don't want to see any information where we have zero values. So I'm making my way up to the column values, come into here, value filter, greater than, and I'm just gonna pop a zero into here, click onto okay, and oh no, I get Steve's information back, okay? And then you start thinking, well, maybe if I just come up here, reset that, and maybe I can just go up to the row labels and do it from there. So value filter greater than, let's just pop it in here then and click onto OK. And I end up with my email addresses again. Now the reason for this is because by default, pivot tables are set up so that you can apply only one filter per field. And that's not helpful here, right? Because every time I go and change the filter on each option, it's eliminating the first filter and obviously replacing it with the new filter. And that's why I have my email addresses back. So how do we deal with this? So what you can do is you can come up to the Pivot Table Analyze tab and make your way over to Pivot Table and onto Options. So that's one way you can do it. Or you can go right click over your values area and go to Pivot Table Options from here. In both ways will open up the Pivot Table Options dialog box. Now make your way to Totals and Filters and pop a check mark against Allow Multiple Filters Per Field. Then click on OK. Okay, should we try this now? If I come up here, do my search, and I don't want them, and click onto OK, and look at that. Isn't that fantastic? Oh, by the way, this has got nothing to do with what we've just done, but this is what I would do here. I would go up to grand totals and I would remove my grand total. And there we go. Now I'm looking at information just for Anne. So if you want to have multiple filters per field in an Excel pivot table, make sure that you make your way up to the Pivot Table Analyze tab or do the right click. Make sure that you come down to Pivot Table Options, onto the totals and filters, and pop this option on. It's so good, right? And of course, when you do that, you will now have a filter here and a filter down here. So good, right? For videos on related topics, please visit my channel. For links to my courses or my weekly tips, check the description box below.